this morning we're going to talk about a woman or a girl named Esther. That's who we're going to talk about. And her name means star. You know how names sometimes mean things. Well, her name means star. Okay. So you know how sometimes in the world people judge us just by how we look or how smart we are, or if we're good at athletics, or if we're popular. You know how sometimes people judge us like that? Without even getting to know us? It doesn't happen in elementary school. You are at the best school. Anybody can have your kid to sign up there. That is a good school. I am glad. But you know what? It even happens to us as adults, doesn't it? Where someone judges us before they even know us. But the good thing is, God never judges that way, because God sees us as we are, the wonderful person that He has created. That we are the special person that has a special purpose. And purpose is kind of like a present you get that you don't know what's inside of it until you unwrap it. It's kind of like that, and we never know when we're going to need to use that special purpose. Well, in our scripture story today, it's probably going to be a letdown, so don't get that excited. Yeah. In our scripture today, there's four people. There's Haman, who is the evil man. So we have to say, what do we say? Haman is the bad guy. We have King Xerxes, we have Esther, and we have Esther's cousin Mordecai. That's what's in our story today. And Esther was, the king was looking for a, Haman works for the king and is kind of a evil, devious man. And the king was looking for a new queen, and the way he kind of found the queen was not by finding out what kind of people they were, just lined up the prettiest girls and picked the one that he liked best. And Esther was beautiful and kind and pleasant, but he didn't know that she was Jewish because she didn't tell him. Okay, so now the time comes when Haman has a plan that is going to kill all the Jews. And because the king doesn't know that Esther's a Jew, she doesn't know what to do. Should she be brave enough to go and tell the king that she's a Jew and to save all of them? Is he so? And I said, yes, right away. I can tell. But she wasn't sure, but by doing that, what might happen to her? Yeah. Her life may be over. So she has to really think it over. And up until now, she believes in God and loves God and worships God, but she's not sure what her purpose or job is. Well, guess what? This is when it was time for her to unwrap her gift and find out what God had given her. And He had given her the gift of courage. It's right on the front of our bulletins today. Big. Courage. We can't. In a sec. She was brave enough to go and talk to the king and said, Haman has this horrible plan. And I don't want that to happen to me or to my people. So she had courage. And we don't always know what our purpose is. Sometimes when we're young, right away we know what we want to do and what God wants us to do. But we don't always know. Now the good thing is, when we unwrap our purpose and find out what it is, and in Esther's case, it was courage. Do you think that that's the only purpose God has for us? Just one purpose? I don't think so. Sometimes after we unwrap the first purpose and we use it, we find out that God has something else for us to do. So we always have to be listening and praying and talking with God to find out what our purpose is. Let's pray. Dear God, You have created us all exactly how we should be. Help us to be looking for what it is that You need us to do to share Your love in the world. Sometimes it's going to take courage to do, but I know we can do it with You by our side.